Hello and welcome back. If you follow the channel, you know that we recently got our sticky hands on a genuine Space Shuttle Teleprinter, thanks to generous collector Marcel. We kid you not, the shuttle had a 59-pound teleprinter on board during its first 10 years of operation, which itself was derived from a 100-pound Navy teletype. So, I guess, good job NASA for at least trying to make it lighter. In part 1, we explain how this apparent absurdity came to be, how it works, with a rotating drum and hammers controlled by an early microprocessor, and how NASA modified it with new electronics. After Masterkin reversed engineered the modifications, we checked the power supplies and tried to turn it on. But nothing came of it. The drum seemed stuck. So it looks like we have mechanical problems to take care of first. So I wouldn't be surprised if there were a few stuck gears in that thing. And so we have to take out the printing mechanism, which doesn't appear to be that difficult. I took the front part out, it disconnects cleanly, there's just a lot of screws. I think it's those screws. The manual says 15 screws and then the mechanism should slide out. Okay, that's 15 screws. Yep, should do the top. Shorter screw. Oh yeah. We got it. Okay, I got it. And I have an inkling that what is wrong is that gear here. Looks completely frozen. It's the one that takes the power for the drum and then moves it to the ribbon. And then the other problem is that we have to recoat this. It's just molten away. Yeah, and there's an identical roller at the bottom. I know I had seen it. You can see it move way at the bottom, down here somewhere. So two rollers we have to redo. And from that side, you can see even better what the problem is. This gear over here, it is just stuck to the plate. I think I can get the hammer assembly out. Oh yeah. Yes. Okay, comes out except for the connector. And then where I'm at it, can test for the hammers. Some are free, some are not free. This one's completely stuck. Okay, so we have to work on the hammers too. These one here, three screws. So I think that's my problem. Normally that should come out, but since this gear is stuck to the plate, it won't. Alright, so I have to there you go. Oh, it's the grease. It's grease. Alright. Oh my, this is pretty majorly caked in. Isopropanol didn't do it, maybe acetone will do it. Yeah, acetone does it. Alright. And it shouldn't even have touched the surface, right? It shouldn't have been any grease in there at all. Okay, so the grease problem continued all the way down. So I took it all apart. I'm going to do light oil instead of grease. Oh, now she purrs. Yeah, it freed it up. It still binds a little bit, so I have to find out what binds. Well, there are some bad news. There is definitely some corrosion damage on the drum. Some of the letters have been eaten away. I think with a toothpick, I might be able to get some of it out, but not all of it. Some is actual damage. Some you can help out, some you can't, like over here, it's gone. All right, it's starting to get there. So another issue, now this is turning, but my paper advance is very, very stiff. And then the rollers here are not moving at all, they're all stuck. All right, I managed to remove the roller bar without having to take out the whole thing, which has been very difficult. And you can see what my problem is, that this stuff has just liquefied. This is just awful, yeah. All right, progress. I managed to free those, and what had happened is that the liquefying material had found its way in between those. But I was able to take a clip and slide them apart, and now it's fine. And it's major problem. So I have progressed in my disassembly, and finally I was able to get this assembly out, which has our big bad roller in it. You notice that I had to dismantle the motor, and the way it's done is weird. So here's the magnet assembly that you slide off. So you have to take off the brush assembly, then the magnet assembly, and then the rotor that's permanently pressed onto the drum. And you need a tool to extract it. So fortunately, I managed to take it apart without having to do that. All right, and I think that's going to come right out. Yes. It is just absolutely awful. It's all molten. You see that, Ken? It is just... It's better to have done that after lunch.
That's kind of gross.
Yeah.
Was it cork originally?
No, I think it's rubber. It's the same rubber that melted away. And separated.
Does not look like space grade rubber.
I wish by now they would invent a rubber that doesn't turn into that kind of mess. Yeah. Almost finished with my horrible cleaning here. Alright, that's my temporary solution for it. I put a piece of tubing that I laying around and heated it up so I could sleeve the roller. It's not the roundest thing in the world. Much better. So that worked perfectly. And I also had to do the other roller, and there I just chose to use some electrical tape. It didn't need to be beefed up by very much. So I think we are ready for the reassembly, which is a bit daunting, I have to say. So at this moment, I think I'm partially out of the woods. So crap, here we go. Oh yes. Alright, so at this point we have the mechanism all put back together. The drum rotates freely now. I might wait to put the ribbon mechanism because we need to adjust the hammer mechanism distance. But phew, it's back together. And our boy Eric has taken the one of the hammer assemblies out.
So you pull it out.
And you have that beauty. Are those stuck or not anymore?
Yeah, they're still stuck. There's the two hammers in the middle here jammed.
So you have five hammers per cassette and you have...
Looks like there's four of them.
Four?
Yeah. They don't move very much. This is
Push, dunk. Yeah, we'll have to realign. There's a very precise spec on how far they have to be. All right. Well, good luck unsticking all the hammers. All right. So before we can try the printer, we have to realign the distance between the hammer and the drum. And for that, you need a very specific distance of 0.411 inches. So I have made this little special tool supposed to go between here. And the drum. We can make it a little too close and then push it. Okay. Ah, we go.
Yeah, I saw that move. That's good.
Okay. That is quick. Can we take them out? We can. And one. Yeah, and two. Okay, so, we are not finished, we need the ribbon.
That's right, and the ribbon assembly.
And the ribbon assembly. And the question is, do we have a ribbon? We probably need to get one from Staples.
In the Space Shuttle ribbon section?
Yes. We are finishing up our connection of the machine. We have wrestled with the ribbon and the paper, threaded both.
Okay.
And then I have what I think is the right modulation. Master Ken, how do you turn it on?
It's been months, I don't remember. Give it power, I think.
Okay, you ready?
Yeah.
Did it actually?
We did print something.
Yeah.
What does it say?
It says,
yeah, it says, welcome to CuriousMarc's channel and here it with us.
Well, but we will have to align the stuff, right? I don't expect it to be aligned.
Paper feed feeds.
That's my two rollers, hey.
Self-test. Self-test says paper load. Well, this is more action than I was expecting. Not actually predictable, but... Wow.
It's printing something. It's printing the characters. Are you in self-test mode or something?
Yeah, I put the self-test mode.
Okay, I guess we... And some are legible.
Okay, I stopped the self-test.
Is this like a... System
this is red.
Initialized, it says.
Oh, system initialized, so it's...
It wants to work.
It's close!
Yeah, look at that.
Oh, well, that's remarkable.
Wow, you have... You know how to read hieroglyphics. We need to figure out how to align the timing and the hammers and all that good stuff. So I wanted to get a shot of the drum.
Okay, ready?
Yeah. Paper transport's still feeble. You see the hammers? They go like crazy. Oh yeah, we do see them. I see them move, and it's not really understandable what it says. Let me stop the test. Okay, and now it says system initialized. Then what I think is happening is that we are not aligned left to right, and I'm missing the column. You have to line it left to right and up and down. We haven't done that yet. Promising. But man, it doesn't feel like a finely crafted piece of space technology.